last week's guest, Mammoth WVH, and I'm All Right.
That's right, Wolfie Bertinelli with the number one. We have so much more music coming for you, plus John Taylor of Duran Duran and Darryl McDaniels of Run-DMC.
And more, all coming up here on the Power Hour.
Buddy, you're alive, very willing to die to shine. Power Hour.
Welcome to the Power Hour, your home for all things rock and metal. I'm Matt Pinfield.
This is Josh Bernstein.
And I'm Katie Babbs.
We've got a great show for you today. Rock and Roll Hall of Famers, John Taylor of Duran Duran, and Darryl McDaniels of Run-DMC.
And don't forget, we're going to count down the top 10 videos of the week that you vote on with the QR code below. Don't forget, vote good, great, okay, or not for me.
And besides our top 10 countdown, we also have 5 brand new music videos to show you.
Including this new one from the Italian band Maneskin. Here's a little bit of Honey, Are You Coming?
Woo! Woo! More of that one from Maneskin in a bit, but right now it's time for music news. What do we got, Josh?
Iron Maiden is going to be headlining the Aftershock Festival next year. They've announced an entire tour. I'm focused on one date, and that's Sacramento, October 24th, 2024. Are we excited or what?
Just when you think Aftershock can't get any bigger, they make it bigger somehow.
I was actually shocked.
You were shocked? Completely shocked.
Now it's time for our Jolly Time good news segment. Now, I feel like all the news this week has been good news, but this one is pretty special. Now, famously, a couple years ago, Christopher Walken was on SNL and introduced the Foo Fighters the wrong way, and it was so cool this weekend. Foo Fighters came back, first performance since we lost Taylor Hawkins, very emotional. They came back, but they brought Christopher Walken, and he said the name correctly.
Is it Foo Fighters?
Is it
Foo Fighters?
Is it Foo Fighters or Foo Fighters?
Foo Fighters.
Yeah. Christopher Walken's amazing.
He's pretty incredible and adorable. We saw the cast, the guys in the Foo Fighters dressed as the cast of The Wizard of Oz for Halloween. It was pretty adorable, but I think that's pretty good. And I love when celebrities and people get sort of make fun of themselves and make fun of their own goofs, so.
Well, I hope that Christopher gets featured in a Foo Fighters music video. I think that would be fun.
Yeah, I mean, he's done it before for other people.
Yeah. Fatboy Slim, right?
Fatboy Slim, that's great. He was dancing in that in such a special way, so he's due. For another video appearance.
He is. Well, that was a jolly time piece of good news here with Christopher Walken.
Answer this question. What song do you have on repeat this week? What can't you get enough of?
Right now, I'm listening to this new artist, Amira Elfiki. I was pronouncing her name wrong for a really long time, but I finally got it right. This song, Coming Down, I believe she's from Los Angeles. She's kind of got this like flyleaf, but a little more edgy vibe. So check out Amira, it's awesome. Coming Down, that's the jam that I'm jamming out to all week long.
I'm on Joey Valence and Bray, Punk Tactics. That's my new jam. I dearly, dearly miss the Beastie Boys, and I feel like these guys are picking up the torch and running with it, and it's a huge hit in the Bernstein Carr household.
I'm glad that's doing really well. You know, for me, I just can't get enough of an artist who's on our countdown. I love and listen to repeatedly Tim Montana.
I knew
it! The Devil You Know.
I knew it!
And there's a new Stone song on that Hackney Diamonds album that I love called Whole Wide World, which is great. So, I mean, that album is full of great songs. A big surprise to come out all these years later.
I'm so glad that you could turn the world onto new bands like the Rolling Stones.
Yeah, exactly.
I hope they get their...
they get their due?
They get their shine, their light here.
All right, well, we were just talking about the new songs that we are enjoying, but now it's time to get into our 5 brand new music videos.
This first new video comes from our good friend Ash Costello. Ash, what's up?
Hey, Katie, Josh, and Matt. It's Ash Costello. A huge thank you for premiering our music video for Vampire tonight on the Power Hour. You guys are the best music show there is, period, hands down, and you're always playing the coolest new songs, so we really, really appreciate it. So the music video concept is I'm battling a vampire, and we had this grand idea of playing on a bell tower with bats circling us and like swords and lightning, And we thought there's no way we're gonna be able to do this without CGI. So this is our first CGI music video. You know, we've never done that before, and we worked really hard on it. So the song is about maybe someone in your life or a group of people that are out to hurt you. They want to kind of suck the life out of you or drain the joy out of you, and like all they're doing is seeking to destroy you. And the song is about telling that vampire in your life that, you know, you're not gonna let them win. So I hope you guys all enjoy the music video. Make sure you all vote, because last time you got us to number one, and it would be awesome to do that again for a music video we worked so hard on. You can buy it. There you have it, our first new music video of the week, New Year's Day with Vampire, and I'm obsessed with that one. It's so heavy. Ash sounds great, and I love that she's been sharing videos of herself in the studio working on all this stuff as well.
I want to shout out, she also performed it live on Halloween Havoc NXT the other night, and I watched it, and I did a spit take. I was so excited for Ash and the band to be performing in front of the wrestling fans. It's so cool.
That is fantastic.
That is pretty badass.
Let's go to our second new video this week. It's from Alkaline Trio. The guys are back with their first album in 6 years since Matt Skiba left Blink 182. So they're back in business. And here is their new song, the title track to their new album, Blood, Hair, and Eyeballs. Ooh. I've got nightmares.
With blood, hair, and eyeballs.
Not a moment too soon, especially on Halloween. A lot of Alkaline Trio fans are going to be so excited that Matt and the boys are back.
That's right, they're back. And of course, it's being released, the album, when it comes out on bone-colored vinyl.
Yes. Well, yeah. When we come back, we still have three brand new music videos for you. Plus, we'll get into our top 10 countdown.
Plus, the legendary John Taylor of Duran Duran.
That's all coming up right here on the Power Hour on Axis TV.
So Matt, like, we're coming back for season two on Access. I'm super excited.
Yeah, but we got a problem. Wayne, I wanted to talk to you about it because they're not giving us a raise. They haven't offered us anything.
I don't want to rock the boat. I don't want to rock the boat.
And I know that you've been dealing with this for so many years. Wayne, what's your advice? What should we do?
My advice is you guys quit being such okay? Go do your job because that's what you're great at and that's what's going to get you.
All right, Wayne Newton right there.
Wow, thanks, Wayne Newton.
Welcome back to the Power Hour on Axis TV, your home for all things rock and metal. I'm Matt Pinfield.
This is Josh Bernstein.
And I'm Katie Babbs.
Well, it's time to get back into our brand new videos for this week, and this one comes from the Italian band who won the Eurovision Song Contest, first rock band to do that since ABBA back in 1974. Of course, they had a big hit with Four Seasons Begging all over the U.S., crossover hit, and they're back with something brand new. This is called Honey, Are You Coming from Maneskin.
All right, that was Maneskin with Honey, Are You Coming? That sounded great. Now, this next video, I love. The video is so funny. It's from the girls Rosie and Carmen in Bones UK. This one's called Ride, and they're calling out men who drive big cars. So let's check this one out.
Why does your car need to be that big? Is it to make up for the size of your tiny dick? Oh my God, that ride is sick, but what a shame you're driving it.
All right, Bones UK with Ride. Now, everybody's been thinking that for years. Everyone just didn't want to say it.
My girlfriend says that all the time, kind of speaks that when someone...
I drive a smart car.
You got tiny little yin-yang if you are revving your engines.
You know, Bones UK are an incredible band. They, of course, were discovered
by Jeff Beck, the late, great Jeff Beck. Like, you know, he heard them playing and then he had them work on one of his albums. He thought they were just incredible. They were nominated for a Grammy, and Howard Stern loved them so much, he asked them to cover I'm Afraid of Americans, the Bowie Nine Inch Nails collab for a Bowie tribute.
Cool.
I mean, they are badass ladies,
yeah,
and we love
ass.
Them.
They got that BDE.
All right, well, getting into the final video of the week, we got Death Valley Dreams. Let's check out a little snippet of it. Go.
That's our final new video of the week, a band from Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania, called Death Valley Dreams. That was Leave Me Alone. Now, the singer of that band, Nick Cole, was in a band called Lifer. He's part of that whole scene Breaking Benjamin came out of. He was even in the band Cold for a little while, but this is the great new project that they're working on. It's a new band, and they played Louder Than Life and Aftershock.
It was great. Cool. Yeah, they sounded wonderful there.
Awesome. Well, when we come back, the top 10 countdown as voted by you will start. Plus,
from Bourbon Beyond, our exclusive interview with John Taylor of Duran Duran.
That's all coming up next, right here on the Power Hour on Axis TV.
What a day.
It's awesome.
Some
Let's
great
go.
Bands,
Let's,
guys.
We'll go backstage.
All right.
Hold on. Hey, yo. We all do a TV show together?
She's our co-host of our TV show.
Oh, with her?
Yeah, we're with her.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
dude.
Right.
No, seriously, we're.
She's got her passes.
Katie.
Welcome back to the Power Hour on Axis TV. We are your home for everything rock and metal. I'm Matt Pinfield.
I'm Josh Bernstein.
It's Katie Babs.
We're going to go back to Bourbon and Beyond this year, where we caught up with Rock and Roll Hall of Famer and legendary artist who started in the 80s, John Taylor of Duran Duran. Let's hear what he had to say. Hey, it's Matt Pinfield, and I'm here with Josh Bernstein, Bourbon and Beyond 2023. We're here with the incredible John Taylor of Duran Duran. John.
Good to see you, Matt. Good to see you, Josh.
To me, you're still... You know, you're still my band, right? You're still our band. I got to watch the Incredible Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction ceremony recently and enjoyed it so much. And Robert Downey Jr. gave such an incredible speech to you guys. What was it like?
You know, Duran have always been, we've been a bit of an outsider band, really. You know, we're not like an industry favorite, I wouldn't say. And I mean, you know, but, you know, you wonder where you are in the circle of life, you know, and then you realize you're sort of somewhere between Judas Priest, Eminem and Dolly Parton. You go, you know, that's okay. I'm all right being
that's
there.
A good party, there. By the way. That's a good place I want to be at.
What was it like when you first came to America?
Oh, my God. We came here first time in 81, I think, behind the first album. And yes, it was college radio. We were like a very niche. We were like an underground band. I think Planet Earth was out. Kids knew a few of the songs. We already had a following. But you know, I think very fondly back to that first time and the second time around. You know, and you meet people after the show, you know, and you talk music, and maybe you go back to their place and listen to music and hang out. You know, it was really sort of free and easy. You know, it was amazing. I mean, I still get a kick out of traveling around this country, and I get a kick out of traveling around this country in a posse. You know, it's a fantastic way to see the world.
Bootlegs of those shows that exist, and the band was great, man. You guys could really play. I mean, you delivered on it live.
We were playing to the peak of our abilities, I'll tell you that. You know, I mean, whatever notes you saw me play with, they were the only notes I knew. You know, I mean, we hadn't been playing that long together. I mean, I think Andy was really the only one that knew the difference between, you know, a major and a minor. You know, everybody else was post-punk. Yeah. You know, we didn't really know that much, but we were playing it with real commitment. You know, and we grew together. That was the thing. It wasn't like any one person was Steve Vai. You know, we were all kind of about the same level. As I say, Andy, maybe the exception, knew a little bit more.
One of my favorite experiences a couple years back, I used to run an event called Bass Player Live, and we had you there, doing a book signing. Now I bring this up because this event for years was. If there was ever a woman attending this event, I never saw her. But John Taylor did a signing. And the situation changed a little. Every time when your name comes up, people always be like, will tell you how good of a bass player truly you are. Mm. Who are the guys, some of the bass players that you know inspired you when you were first playing?
Well, the first bass player that I really listened to and thought maybe I could be a bass player was Bernard Edwards from Chic, you know, and it, you know, some of those lines like Everybody Dance and Good Times particularly, because I wasn't really hearing the nuance. I was hearing what appeared to be the deceptive simplicity of what he was playing, and you know, and that kind of inspired me to pick up a bass and play with Roger. And I was playing guitar when Roger first came over and started jamming with us. I was still playing guitar, still thought maybe that was my thing. And one afternoon there was a bass line around and I picked it up and I just locked in to his kick and snare, and I thought, oh man, this is where I want to live. And then Bernard, who I got to work with, turned me on to James Jameson, who was the Motown house bass player. And, you know, and I mean, since then, you know, I'm really into the guy from the Philadelphia house band. I mean, obviously McCartney is amazing.
When, you know, you go back to the first album and put on Friends of Mine, you put a friend of mine, or, you know, you'll pull something off of Rio or one of the other early records, or Seven and a Ragged Tiger. It's just great when you reach back for your fans who love those albums and
yeah, no, it was a great time for music, that whole post-punk era. You know, everybody was invigorated by punk, really, you know, and, you know, it sort of exploded that whole prog sort of, you know, that sort of complacent thing that had been happening in rock in the later 70s. It just blown it up, you know, and you had all this young energy, like people like us, you know, who just had this will to make something happen, you know, and I don't know, it was the music was exciting, you know, new wave, you know, it was like it had the energy of punk, but we were listening to disco, we were listening to funk, we were listening to electronic music, so there was a lot of, you know, whereas punk was like very single-minded, you know, and very like one-dimensional in a great way, but what came after had the energy of punk, but it had a greater variety of musics coming into it, you know, and influencing it.
Kind of meshing all those things and influences and styles that they loved. So there's a lot of different bands with different personalities.
Yeah. I mean, isn't it amazing? I mean, around about the time when over here people were burning disco records.
Yeah.
I mean, how narrow-minded can you get?
Yeah.
You know, we now know that, you know, music is like the broadest church in the world, right?
Yeah.
And if you're into music, it doesn't matter what music you're into. You're into music.
Yeah.
And the more you're into music, the more you like all different sorts of music, I always feel, you know. But like, not so long ago, they were burning disco records at the stake.
I think it was 5 Cent Beer Night too, which probably didn't help matters.
Yeah. 5 Cent Beer Night at the Chicago.
Yeah, at the Comiskey Park, yeah. It was a disaster. I mean, I think, you know, sadly some of that is, you know, rooted in some, you know, deep-seated racism or homophobia of what was going on there.
Right, right, right.
But yeah, it's crazy, right? We're even burning Beatles records.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
That is it. All those things are just still.
Colonel Tom Parker will be like, "I'll sell you two to buy and two to burn."
Right.
You know?
Exactly. It's unbelievable stuff.
John, you know, final question before we go. You know, I imagine, you know, your music must mean so much to so many people, and you've gotten to probably hear so many incredible stories from fans. Is there any stories that you've heard over the years of fans you've met that, you know, have told you stories of how much, you know, your music has impacted their life?
I mean, I heard from someone that had come from the Eastern Bloc, as it was called, who learned to speak English through our lyrics, you know, and there's definitely a comedic moving in that, I think. You know, like the only turns of phrases he knew were like ones he got from Le Bon's lyrics, you know.
Yeah.
Where it's like, man, that guy must have been
up. What is this guy talking about?
That's great.
Keeps talking about a reflex. I'm not sure what's
exactly.
Going on.
Exactly. Why, yay, bop, bop, my.
This doesn't make any sense.
Phenomenal. Oh, man, I love it.
Well, that's a good answer to the question.
That is an incredible answer.
I mean, John, we can't thank you enough for being here.
Pleasure.
With us. Quite an honor on the Power Hour. I told Matt many times it's lonely being a very handsome bass player, so and you know the struggle.
So lonely.
It's like,
so lonely.
We strive on.
Yes.
And
you got to do it.
I admire your courage in doing it. And thank you for being here.
Thank you
enough.
It's so great. It's great to have you here on the Power Hour and at Bourbon and Beyond 2023. It's Matt Pinfield and Josh Bernstein with the great John Taylor of Duran Duran.
Well, there you go, John Taylor of Duran Duran from Bourbon and Beyond with Josh and Matt. I'm so jealous
It was pretty cool, but you know, we can't hang out with Wayne Newton all the time, so we had to
share the mic a little. It's time for you to see the videos that you voted into the top 10 this week. And don't forget, vote for all of them. What do they have to say?
Great, good, okay,
not for me.
Great, good, okay, not for me.
Great, good, okay, not for me.
Okay, here's the number 10 video that you voted on this past week. It was one of our guests last week, Courtney LaPlante and Spiritbox. This is called Cellar Door at 10. Transform my death into a conduit. This body's separate from the filter. Let's sign a coping mechanism of monotony. I will destroy the deprivation that I was forced to run.
Number 10. Cellar Door from Spirit Box. Had such a great time with Courtney last week, and you know what? I've decided to forgive her on the Tim Hortons comment. It's fine. It's fine.
There was so many shots fired, espresso shots fired during that fight here. But I'm glad you guys could mend fences and say sorry.
I can move past it.
Did she say sorry?
We both say sorry.
Okay.
You say sorry. If you say sorry. Then you're definitely in that Canadian flow.
Well, yes. I'm really sorry, but we gotta move on to number 9.
Woo! All right, coming in at number 9, it's imposter syndrome from guitar superstar wonderkind Sophie Lloyd and her good friend, our good friend, Lizzie Hale. Here, let's check it out.
That's Imposter Syndrome from Sophie Lloyd with some help from the great Lizzie Hale. And speaking of Lizzie Hale, I found this when I was cleaning out my storage, which is an invitation to a Hailstorm showcase back when her and RJ were literally 15, 16 years old. This is what was sent to me in the mail.
Now, what is that?
It's Hailstorm. It's like a demo and an invitation to their show.
So Katie, that's called it's called a CD.
It's called a CD.
Okay, screw you guys, I'm not that young, Jesus.
It's called a compact.
I'm a 91 baby, we had tapes and VHSs. You know we love Lizzie Hale, but we gotta move on. When we come back, the top 10 countdown continues.
Plus our chat with Darryl McDaniels of Run-DMC. Plus, where will Wolfgang Van Halen end up on our list?
We'll have that and much more coming up on the Power Hour right here on Axis TV. Stay with us.
Okay, warming up. You ready?
I'm not the one who's so far away when I feel the snake bite enter my veins.
Welcome back to the Power Hour on Axis TV, your source for all things rock and metal. I'm Matt Pinfield.
I'm Josh Bernstein.
And I'm Katie Babb.
And we've got a roll on with the countdown right now. And this band has the number one album in the country. That's right, it beat even the Rolling Stones. Number one, it's from the album called One More Time. Check it out. Blink 182 as the Ramones in Dance With Me. Ole, 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 ole.
Gabba gabba hey, that was Blink 182 with their brand new song, Dance With Me. Incredible. This next one here has been up and down on the charts, bouncing around, but obviously causing a lot of attention and a lot of feelings. This one's called Here and Now by Aaron Lewis and Stain.
Moving up one spot on the list this week to number 7 with Here and Now. And moving on to our next one, we got the Rolling Stones with a song that absolutely does not make us angry. It actually makes us very happy, but it's titled Angry. So here you go.
Why angry? Voices keep echoing, calling out my name. Hear the rain keep beating on my window pane. I hear a melody ringing in my brain. You can keep the memories, don't have to be ashamed. Don't get angry with me.
That's the Rolling Stones at number 6 with the debut single from their new album, Hackney Diamonds, called Angry. The album came in at number 3 this week on the Billboard charts. Rock and roll is still on the top. Next up at number 5, you voted it here with the sons of Phil Collins and Steve Lukather, their new band called The Effect. This is Unwanted.
Seem to be lost in time, but I guess I'll be.
Effect with Unwanted. Incredible. This next one is from one of my favorite bands. We got to see them headline at Louder Than Life. This is Green Day, and this video takes me back a little to American Idiot. It's sort of that same sort of vibe.
Yeah, yeah.
But this one is called The American Dream Is Killing Me. Is American Dream killing you?
Most of the time.
Fantastic. Yeah. Let's check out the video right now.
At number 4, that's Green Day with their brand new one, The American Dream Is Killing Me. They have announced the name of the new album. It's called Saviors. It'll be out in the new year, and they're going to be our guests, all 3 of them, right here on the Power Hour very soon.
And when we come back, we're going to be chatting with Daryl of Run-DMC. It's tricky, 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 tricky,
huh? Plus, we got your top 3 videos of the week, and that's all coming up here on the Power Hour, only on Access TV.
Welcome back to the Power Hour on Access TV. I'm Matt Pinfield.
I'm Josh Bernstein.
I'm Katie Babs.
Our next guest is incredible, a Rock and Roll Hall of Famer and a pioneer of hip hop and rap, one of the all-time greats. It's Darryl McDaniels of Run-DMC. DMC himself.
What's going on? DMC and a place to be. I know a lot about places to be. And with you guys, it's the best place to ever be.
Yeah, hey, Darryl, you know, I always say this. You know, I know what a lover of rock you are. I mean, certainly you came out with Rock Box and King of Rock, those 2 pioneering Run-DMC singles, and you were the first band to really mesh rock with rap and hip-hop.
When I was growing up in Queens, New York, radio was beautiful. There was AM radio that played everything. They played Sly and the Family Stone, James Brown, but they also played Led Zeppelin and Black Sabbath and Neil Young and Harry Chapin and Joni Mitchell. But you know, as a kid, soul music or black music was my mother and father's music because they were cool. I'm just a little kid, but I was in a comic book. But when I started hearing the rock songs on the radio, the guitars and the drums, it was a little bit stronger and louder than soul and R&B. So I was this superhero kid. Every time I heard a rock song, you know, whether it was Black Sabbath or whether it was Led Zeppelin or even the Beatles and the Rolling Stones, I was like, what is this? 79 hip-hop starts. In the streets of New York, a lot of the DJs like Grandmaster Flash and Kool Herc and the Grand Wizard Theodore, they were playing some of the rock songs that was on the radio, but they were using the breakbeat parts. So I said, if I ever make a record, I really wanted to be a rock star, but I couldn't sing like Freddie Mercury. So hip-hop gave this little kid who had this little black kid who loved hip-hop from Queens. Hip-hop allowed my rock and roll dream to come true. Because I said, if I'm going to do hip-hop songs, I'm going to put some rock guitars on it. And Matt, that's why we did Rock Box.
What's it like now celebrating the 50th anniversary of hip-hop? It feels like a couple weeks ago it was created.
Nobody thought it was going to last. Even when we had Walk This Way and we was doing the Adidas deals and everything, everybody was like, excuse me, DMC, where will you be in 3 years? Because they thought it was a fad. But people forget there's no hip hop if there's no music. There's still more tunes, more songs, and more innovative, creative ideas to do.
What is coming for Run-DMC? What is coming for you? What are you up to with music? And who would you eventually like to collaborate with? Like, just give us a rundown.
Well, Run actually just dropped a new song with New Edition. A couple of weeks ago, I hooked up with Patriarchs in Black, my man Dan Lorenzo, and John Kelly. And we got a song out now, a metal song that's rock and rolling, hipping and hopping, and heavy. If you like Black Sabbath, you'll be like, yo, these guys did Black Sabbath awesome. November 11th, I'm dropping a song. It's me and Sebastian Bach on vocals.
Yeah.
Oh!
That's going to be great.
You heard it here on the Power Hour first.
You and Sebastian.
Me and Sebastian. But check this out. Hold up. It's Duff McKagan from Guns N' Roses on bass, Mick Mars from Motley Crue on guitar, and Travis Barker, the one and only Travis Barker.
Yeah.
That's
going to be incredible, man. I cannot wait to hear that collaboration. And that's because you've got so much love and respect from all of those guys. So everybody there is just like, what a lineup of.
That's like the best dodgeball team I've ever heard of.
It brings all these generations together. It brings people together. We live in a very divisive and disrespectful time. And what me, Travis, Mick, and Duff is doing, we're showing the world this is what life is about. Us together, having fun, sharing ideas, and making everybody smile. The single is called She Gets Me High. And just to tease y'all, it's gonna blow your mind. It's a remake of Ram Jam's Black Betty.
Whoa! Oh. I am so glad you're doing Black Betty. That's like one of my all-time favorite songs. You know, when you...
Yo, Matt, we did it just for you, man.
Now, Darryl, we know that DMC stands for Darryl McDaniels, Devastating Mic Control. Darryl makes comics. But I hear Darryl makes cookies.
If you know what I do, when I'm not touring, when I'm not at a comic con, I'm always doing stuff for families and schools, especially with foster kids. But since I've been in this business, everywhere you go, there's a craft table. Everywhere you go, there's a after work event, a wine tasting event, and stuff. And cookies is always around. So a couple of years ago, I was at this event, and I made a joke. You know what? I'm gonna make some cookies. And I'm gonna call my company DMC, Darryl Makes Cookies, and everybody in the room got highly excited about it. And it's just something that I wanna do. In addition to all the music that I've been doing, I like to do stuff that make people smile and bring people together.
When we became friends, that was a thing that I knew, and his passion for rock and roll and just love of music and people is just one of the beautiful
things.
And Matt,
I just wanna commend you. I wanna thank you for what you have done for our genre, what you have done for the culture. I appreciate when I first met you is because you called me over and said you wanted to speak to me. And I think that's the beauty of it. It's all about us having a great relationship with each other and having conversation and participation. That's how we create a better nation.
Absolutely. That's fantastic. Thank you. I am honored and humbled. Absolutely. And you know, I love you, Darryl. Darryl, let's talk about some of the other creative things that you do, because we were talking about comics too, right?
Yeah. So, you know, Darryl, I get to see Darryl a lot, as he mentioned, at all the comic conventions, and Darryl makes incredible comics. And what I love, we did a cool panel with Darryl a couple years ago, and he explained that growing up, the Incredible Hulk, the Uncanny X-Men, right? All these comics influenced how... They're hip-hop names, you know?
Exactly.
And I thought it was so fascinating.
Yeah, alter egos. You know, all of us, I mean, it's very cliche. All of us have superhero abilities. But for me, it was like, you know, I was this shy little Catholic school kid who wore glasses, who lived in Queens, who got teased, bullied, and picked on. And then it was rock and roll and hip-hop who allowed mild-mannered college Queens kid Darryl McDaniels to transform into the devastating mic-controlling king of rock. And to show you how it works, Thor is the son of Odin from Asgard. He has a brother named Loki, and he has a hammer. My father's name is Byford. I got a brother named Alfred, and I got a mic. So hip-hop and rock and roll, through the expression of comic books, allowed Darryl McDaniels to become son of Byford, brother of Al. banners my mother and runs my pal. It's McDaniels, not McDonald's. These rhymes are Darryl, those burgers are Ronald's. I ran down my family tree, my mother, my father, my brother, and me. So rock and roll and hip hop set it up for me to use my imagination to tell comic book type stories on the microphone. Culturally, we are all products of pop culture. Like, there's something that blesses you and sparks something in you to at least want to become incredible like Matt Pinfield.
But we're going to do this fun little special that we do here on the Power Hour. It's called Jolly Time. Sophie's okay. Choice questions. We're going to get try to make it tough for you.
Jetsons or Flintstones? You can only choose one.
Flintstones.
Yeah. Kiss or the Ramones?
I got to go with the Ramones, baby.
Cookies or comics?
Whoa.
Yeah, made hard choices.
I told you I was going to make it difficult.
Oh, you made it real difficult. Yeah. Oh, you know what? I got to go with comics.
Yeah.
Crush Groove or Tougher Than Leather?
Whoa, man.
They're both ignored by the Oscars, but they're fantastic.
Yeah, Tougher Than Leather is such a cult classic. And, you know, what's funny about Tougher Than Leather, I got to go with Tougher Than Leather, because we tried to make it ourselves. We thought we knew what we was doing. We took all our own money and Rick Rubin directed it. It was crazy. So just for the attempt to create our own Hollywood here in Lower Manhattan, I'll go with Tougher Than Leather.
Tougher Than Leather.
That's great. Fred Williamson or Jim Brown?
Oh, I got to go with Fred Williamson. Hell up in Harlem, baby.
Yeah.
Thanks for doing Jolly Time with us, Darryl. And thank you so much for being a guest on the Power Hour. It was so much fun getting to hang out with you.
No, y'all have
really appreciate it.
Y'all have the best hour in the business. So
we love you, and we're excited. We're excited to have you come back and join us very soon in here.
Will do.
That was such a great conversation with Darryl of Run-DMC. He's such like an upbeat, positive guy.
I want to hang out with him every day.
Me too.
So do I. You know, but we'd have to move back to Queens.
Gotta go back to that. Well, he's in Jersey now. He's in Jersey. You moved out of Jersey.
Well, when we come back, we are continuing the countdown with your three top videos.
That's
who's it gonna be?
That's, I don't know, but if you want to find out, you've got to stay right here at the Power Hour on Access TV. Welcome back to the Power Hour on Access TV. We're getting towards the end of the show. I'm Matt Pinfield.
I'm JDB.
I'm Katie Taps.
Well, let's look at what the countdown looks like so far. There's so many great videos on there this week. Why don't we check out a little bit of the Blink 182 since they have the number one album in the country, but you recognize this concept from another video.
Of course, Blink is giving a great homage there to the great I Want to Be Sedated video by the Ramones, which is so beloved with Joey, Johnny, Dee Dee, and Marky Ramone there. And I think they did such a good job. They kind of look like the guys.
They really do.
Yeah.
They transform, and I don't even think they put on too much makeup. They just look
good
with us.
They just like to have a good time. You can always count on Blink 182 for having a fun music video.
And I hope, God forbid, you know, some fans, young fans, go back and discover some great Ramones music.
Those guys are going to be killing it on tour this coming year with Pierce the Veil opening up.
That's going to be awesome. Well, let's move on to our top three and the number three spot this week.
Uh-oh.
Here it comes.
Stretch.
You ready?
Number three this week is Tim Montana. Apparently, I have all the people in the bar saying his name like that now.
Oh, it's the only way to say it.
It's Devil You Know, number three. I'm going. With Devil You Know.
Tim Montana, you know, like we said, Dave Grohl, Billy Gibbons. Do you know also David Letterman invited him to his ranch in Montana when he heard him play? So that guy's got unbelievable rock and TV celebrities that are just big fans of his, including us.
Wait a second, our number two spot, it must mean we have a brand new number one. Who's number two this week?
Oh my God. Well, he's always number one in my heart because. And he's number one in his mother's heart. That's right. I'm talking about Wolfgang Van Halen, our co-host, our dear friend, coming to the number two spot. Now, is it number one? No, but he's all right. And here's the song, I'm All Right.
Wolfgang Van Halen and Mammoth WVH, and I'm all right in the number two spot this week, which means we have a brand new number one. Let's hear it, guys.
One, two, three, Foo Fighters!
This is Under You. It's the Foo Fighters, number one on the Power Hour this week.
The Foo Fighters claiming the number one spot, taking it from their tour mate, Wolfgang Van Halen, next year. Guys, incredible. What a great performance. Great appearance on SNL this week with both Christopher Walken and her. A great performance. Guys, we're going to be back next week. We have so many great guests. We're going to paint it black next week. We got the Black Crows, the Black Keys, and Black Label Society. Oh, my God.
The three Bs.
That's
we got
right.
them all right here
Triple B.
Next week.
Let me remind you, you have to vote for your favorite videos every single week, and that means all of them. Great, good, okay, or not for me. And don't forget, all you gotta do is scan that QR code below the three of us and get voting.
Super easy. But before we get out of here, let's check out that brand new music video for New Year's Day and Vampire. I'm loving this one. Heavy as hell. You can buy it.
Well, that's our show for this week. Again, next week, we go all black. Black Crows, Black Keys, Black Label Society, and all the videos you love and voted for. I'm Matt Pinfield.
This is Josh Bernstein.
And I'm Katie Babbs.
And it's like that.
And that's the way it is.